People became aware that Glamour was not resting in peace. He wrought such havoc that some people fainted at the sight of him, while others went out of their minds. The Draugr is an undead beast whose origins draw from Norwegian mythology and is, for modern reference, very much like a cliched modern zombie with super strength and various magical powers. According to lore, they often live in their graves or mounds and guard various treasures when they are not causing turmoil and disaster on the living, especially those who wrong them in life. These beasts can increase their size at will, which also increases their weight. Thorolf of the Eyrbyggjar saga was uncorrupted, with an ugly look about him, swollen to the size of an ox. They can become smoke or wisps and navigate through solid rock. They slayed their victims by crushing them with their giant forms, consuming them, sometimes whole, killing them by driving them mad, and by drinking their blood. One of many similarities that often ties them historically and in a more modern sense to vampirism. They had a voracious appetite for living flesh. During the first night, Aran got up from his chair and killed the hawk and hound and ate them. On the second night, he got up again from his chair and killed the horse and tore it to pieces. Then he took great bites at the horse flesh with his teeth, the blood streaming from his mouth all the while he was eating. The third night, Asmund became very drowsy, and the first thing he knew, Aran had got him by the ears and tore them off, from Gautrek's saga. Animals feeding near one would be driven insane. Thorolf caused birds to fall to their deaths when they flew over his barrow. They would also roam about, destroying livestock, and in some cases rode them to death. A particularly hideous thought, a demonic-looking super zombie riding an animal to death. The oxen, which had been used to haul Thorolf's body, were ridden to death by demons, and every single beast that came near his grave went raving mad and howled itself to death. From the Eyrbyggjar saga, they are known to possess Trollskap, which consists of numerous dark magical abilities not unlike those of witches and wizards. The ability to shape change, control the weather, see into the future, cause disease and darkness in the day, and even curse a victim are all possessed by the Draugr. In an ability that perhaps directly ties them to the entities appearing in sleep paralysis and the old hag syndrome, they are able to enter dreams and can shape change into a cat that would sit upon a sleeper's chest, growing in size until the victim suffocated. Finding examples of the old hag syndrome and sleep paralysis victims describing an entity sitting on their chests, paralyzing or crushing them, sometimes specifically a cat, within victims of the phenomenon is actually quite common. Perhaps sleep paralysis, the old hag syndrome, and the entire phenomenon, including the oftentimes described shadow people and the hat man, are actually shape-changing Draugr. Their presence would sometimes be shown like a great light from afar, creating a barrier between the lands of the living and those of the dead. Some are immune to weapons, and a hero is often needed to wrestle them and drive them back into the grave. The body would then need disposing of. The best method seemed to be decapitation, followed by immolating the body and dumping the ashes into the sea. Their color was said to range between corpse pale and coal black. Glamour was reported as blue and evil-looking in the Laxdæla saga. In the Eyrbyggjar saga, a shepherd's neck is broken by a blue-black Draugr. He later rises as a Draugr himself. Their motivations seem to be composed mostly of jealousy and greed. A deep-rooted hatred and jealousy of the living exists. The most likely indication a corpse will become a Draugr is if it is found in an upright or sitting position. Evil and marginal people seem to be the most likely candidates for revival. To prevent a corpse from becoming a Draugr, often open scissors were laid across their chest. Small pieces of straw were sewn crosswise under the shroud. The big toes were tied together. Needles were run through the soles of their feet, And when the coffin bearers carried the coffin within the threshold of the door, they raised and lowered the coffin 3 times in alternating directions, as to form a cross. And the parson in the graveyard then used magical words to bind the dead. In later mythology, the draug is often used to define the spirits of drowned mariners. This creature has a distinct human form, except that its head is made entirely of seaweed, sometimes shown as a headless fisherman, and sometimes as shape changers who appear as moss-covered stones and seaweed. Ideas defined in paintings from Theodore Kittelsen, as well as literal links to the draug and the sea, from authors like Jonas Lie and Regine Nordman. The idea of draugs living in the mountains is presented in Heinrich Ibsen's Peer Gynt, while the Nynorsk's translation of Tolkien's The Lord of the Rings used the term draugr to define both the Nazgul and the dead of Dunharrow. The Barrow Whites of the same work bear similarity and were supposedly inspired by the Haugby, a Norwegian creature very much like the draugr. The video game The Elder Scrolls V: Skyrim depicts draugr as undead fallen warriors inhabiting ancient Nordic-inspired burial sites. In the 2018 video game God of War, draugr are a common enemy. I am sure they pop up far more often than this in pop culture, especially fantasy gaming. But for our purposes, in my channel, our most direct pop culture representation of them, and my initial exposure to the actual name and mythology, comes from the epic zombie film, Dead Snow, and its genius sequel, Dead Snow 2, in which a troop of Nazi draugr, led by Standartenfuhrer Herzog, wreak havoc on the local populace, for reasons such as wanting back treasure, revenge, and the completion of his final mission. It is on this Norwegian-based lore and mythology Tommy Wirkola created the Nazi draugr of Dead Snow. Although these Nazi zombie representations are very much influenced and based on the mythological draugr, in many ways they are a far cry from what is depicted in mythology. Lacking most of the draugr's mythological abilities beyond super strength. While possessing many direct mythologically based draugr traits, like the desire to reclaim their treasure, the desire to obtain revenge, as well as dying on and having their tomb in a mountain, and quite possibly sharing the need for a hero to physically wrestle or subdue them before they can be slain. As Herzog does physical battle with Martin, and is physically beaten, at least at one point, before his head is blown to the mountains far away. For completionists, this did not finish him, and his head is shown to have survived after the film ends. Maybe in Dead Snow 3 they will actually immolate and send the remains to the sea, as legend tells us is the best way to deal with a draugr. If you're interested in either of these films, I have linked my reviews in the description below, as well as linked them in the upper right hand side of the screen. Please realize this is a relatively light dive, and I am sure the mythology and influence of these beasts is very much deeper than we have skimmed. If you are interested, reading the old Nordic sagas would be the best primary source for finding the actual mythology of these undead monstrosities. Also, it is key to point out that the traditional pronunciation of draugr, I have most probably completely butchered. This appears to be the case when Herzog calls out his troop. It is important to remember that he has a German accent, and is likely butchering the pronunciation himself. But he clearly says, Having said that, I likely butchered many Norwegian pronunciations, and overall, I am sorry. Thank you so much for wading through the dark histories of the draugr, 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 dragger, digger, I have new videos coming out all the time, so please hit that like and subscribe. And until then, keep sleepwalking, my friends.